Hello guys, today I will show you guys how to make glass game from Squid Game in Unity. This is very simple and it's very fun after you have finished it. Now enjoy the video. Let's create two platforms, which is the start and the end. You can make this long or short and this will decide how many jumps it takes for you to get to the end. So now right click at the hierarchy, 3D object, select cube, and let's name this the platform 1. Okay, and let's reset its position to 0, 0. And let's make it back a little bit. So let's make it negative 30 in the Z axis. And then let's scale it in the X and the Z axis so it's the player can jump and moving around on it. So let's change the scale to 10 in the x-axis and 5 in the z-axis. So now let's duplicate this using Control D and then rename this to platform 2. And let's move it to positive 30 in the z-axis. So now we have a start and a end platform. Now let's create some platform that so the player can jump on. So first let's right click the hierarchy, 3D object, cube, and let's say that glass 1. Let's reset its position and then go to our platform 1. So we want to move it right here. Let's make the number an integer. And now we want that there's two paths. So there's one glass to the left and one glass to the right. So let's move the glass to the left a little bit. So 4.5 is okay. Now let's scale it up in the x-axis. So let's see, I think 5 is okay. So let's rearrange this. Let's test 2.5 and this looks good to me. Now let's scale it up in the z-axis so the player will have more ground when jumping on the glass. Let's make this also 5, so we want our glass to be a square. Now let's change this to negative 20. No, this is 2.4, so let's 22.5. And yeah, that looks good. Now let's duplicate this using Control D. Rename this to glass 2 if you want to, and then move it aside a little bit, so negative 2.5. and now we have two glasses, but as you can see the glass are touching each other, so you can fix this by changing the scale in the x-axis. Let's say 4.5 and 4.5, both of the glasses, and as you can see now there's a gap between the two glass. But if our player jump right in the middle of these glasses, the player will eventually break one of the glasses, but they are still alive because they're standing on the other platform. So that's 4, and then let's move this so that the player cannot jump the two, cannot touch the two platforms at the same time. So let's negative 3 in the x, negative 3, no, 3, just 3. Okay, so now this looks better. Let's just change it so that the x and the z scale is the same, so we have a square. Now we just need to duplicate these two glass. and then control D, move it a little bit. So let's see. So we want the distance between each two glasses should be the same. So right here. So let's repeat this until we reach the end. So control D. Okay. And then control D last time. And this looks good. Now let's just scale. Let's change the Y scale so the glass looks less thick. So 0.5 looks good. Now let's add some material for our glass. So right click at the assets, create, and select material. Let's name this glass material. And now change the rendering mode from opaque to transparent. And then in the color section, change the alpha channel, which is the transparency of an object, to 0. And let's apply it to our glass. So as you can see, our glass has some kind of transparent, so we can look through it. Let's select all the glass and add a glass material to it. Okay, let's make it a bit more blue. So let's turn on the emission in the HDR, select the cyan color and then drag it, but don't make it too bright. And I think this looks good to me. Let's fall through the glass when we touch it. Let's change one of the glass and remove its mesh collide, the box collider. So this means that when we touch it, it's gonna just fall right through it. So let's test with a cube rigid body object, which is a cube that affects by the gravity. So let's move it right here and add a rigid body component to it. And when we play the program, you can see that the cube fall right through the glass. So let's repeat this to all the glass as well. So let's say that I will select it randomly. Okay, now all this and select box collider, remove components. Now we need a first person script. So I found a video very interesting from Brackies, so I will leave the link in the description down below. And after you follow his tutorial, let's come back to our program. After you have followed the entire tutorial and you test and it works, you just need to copy my stats right here. So speed is 6, jump height is equal to 2, and everything, the ground mass is ground, which I assign to every platform in the game. So everything is layered ground. Okay, now let's test our game out. So let's hit the play and let's see. Okay, so let's try and jumping on one of the platforms. So this, okay, so we're alive. Let's continue jumping on this. And as you can see, we have chose the wrong glass and fall right through it, just simply because there's no box collider on this glass. Perfect. This is the end of this video. Hope you guys enjoy it. And in the next video, we will make particles when the glass break and what happens when the player fall down or win.